The Indian Space Research Organization, or ISRO, announced plans to launch a rover to the moon sometime in July of 2019. Not only will this be India's first attempt to land on our big gray satellite, the mission is going where no one has gone before, the moon's south pole. They won't be alone for long though, because Jeff Bezos' space company, Blue Origin, is planning a trip to the lunar south pole as well. But why the sudden interest? What could be down there that's worth seeing? Turns out, quite a bit, and it could be the key to a human colony in space. Up to this point, only three other nations have landed probes on the moon: the former Soviet Union, the United States, and China, in that order. An Israeli organization made an attempt in April of 2019, but their Bereshit's lander rocket failed in the final moments before touchdown, adding another tiny crater to the moon's face and leaving fourth place in the lunar rover race up for grabs. So India's ISRO is the next to take their shot, launching their lander Vikram with the rover Pragyan tucked away inside on a mission they're calling Chandrayaan 2. Yes, while this is their first attempt at landing on the moon, it's not their first mission to it. In October of 2008, ISRO's Chandrayaan 1 mission sent an orbiter to the moon. It operated for 312 days while a NASA instrument on board studied the moon's surface. In 2018, it was announced that those observations revealed what appears to be water ice on the surface of the moon's polar regions. That's what's kicked off this race to the poles. Now, don't go picturing massive ice sheets like what the Earth has. For now, anyway. The moon's ice is sparse and probably mixed in with the regolith. You may be wondering how ice could exist on the moon at all, and truth be told, we're not sure how it got there. It could be from early volcanism, or the ice could have been brought there by impactors, but we know how it stays there. At the poles, because the sun is edge-on to the moon, the insides of some craters are in permanent darkness. And inside these craters, it's cold. The temperature never rises above -156°C. Since it's forever dark down there, the ice doesn't get the chance to evaporate, and estimates predict that there could be anywhere from 10,000 to 100 million tons of ice at the South Pole. That's great news for us because, and I don't know if you've heard, but humans need water to live. So if we could extract it from the moon instead of bringing it with us from Earth, that could save a lot of rocket fuel. Speaking of rocket fuel, it just so happens that it's made of hydrogen and oxygen. And guess what has a lot of hydrogen and oxygen in it? Really hope you said water or I'm really failing at my job. So, given the enormous benefits of water ice, it's starting to look like a lunar colony at one of the poles would be ideal. Well, except for the cold and the fact that permanent shadows aren't conducive to solar power. But that's where the pole's unique geometry with the sun comes into play again. The same way some craters have permanent shadow, some mounds, crests, and crater rims at the poles see near constant daylight, some for more than 200 consecutive Earth days. And some of these sunny spots are right next to craters that could contain ice. One such place is the Shackleton crater, and that's Blue Origin's targeted landing spot. Even if ISRO beats Blue Origin to the punch, Bezos' company is still planning serious polar exploration. They've unveiled a mock-up of a lander capable of carrying 4 rovers and have designed an alternate version that would be able to carry 6.5 metric tons, including an ascent stage that would enable astronauts to visit the moon. So, ISRO's Chandrayaan 2 mission could be more than just a feather in the cap of India's space agency. It'll be our first chance to get down in the regolith and see just how abundant the ice is. If the mission fails, however, like Bereshit did, Blue Origin could wind up being the first to the South Pole, as well as the first private company to land on the moon. No matter who gets there first, confirming abundant ice at the South Pole could be a huge milestone in human history. If it could sustain a lunar colony and produce rocket fuel, then the moon's south pole could be the first stop on a journey to Mars and beyond. The Vikram lander is tentatively set to touch down September 6th, 2019, and we will be watching it very closely indeed. Thanks for watching, be sure to subscribe because we've got tons of great videos like this one asking how close are we to a lunar colony. If we find enough ice at the South Pole, would you be willing to live on the moon? Let us know why or why not in the comments, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.